Thursday's video was no talking, only pretty pictures. Today, it's the opposite. Today's wall-to-wall talking. Well, I'll probably stick a picture or two in, like this one, and this one, and this one. You've probably seen some version of this quote before. There are dozens, there might be hundreds of memes that feature it. It's usually some grand, pretty scene with the text superimposed on top. Sometimes the quote goes uncredited, but usually it's credited to Toni Morrison, and rightfully so, because it did originate with Toni Morrison. But it's not actually what she said. Why does that matter? Why does it have to be exactly what she said? Well, I'm going to tell you right after this little theme song plays.
Maximalist Minibus with Mary and Captain and you. Get on the bus!
So, if you want to fly, you have to give up the things that weigh you down. It's a good quote. It speaks to the nomad experience, right? Because for a lot of us, you know, looking to leave sticks and bricks and go to mobile life, we have a lot of things weighing us down. But like I said, that's not the real quote. The line is from Song of Solomon, which is a novel by Toni Morrison. It's a book that blends fantasy and reality in magical ways. It's full of allegory and symbolism. And the line that we're talking about comes as two characters are watching this white peacock on the hood of a car. It spreads its tail feathers. It's putting on this big display, even though it's white. You know, it's stripped of the brilliant color that you usually expect from a peacock. On the surface, the line is about how, even though it has wings, the peacock can't get airborne because of its massive, showy tail feathers. What the character of guitar actually says in the book is, can't nobody fly with all that shit. Want to fly? You got to give up the shit that weighs you down. That's the real quote. And I'm not complaining that the quote's gotten cleaned up. I mean, it makes sense. You know, more polite words look better on a pretty picture that you can post to your Facebook profile. Some people get turned off by what we call four-letter words, and we don't want to push people away, you know, so it's changed a little bit. But there's a lot of sanitizing that goes on in our world, both in terms of this is how nomad life is and just, you know, life in general. We want things to be neat and tidy and perfect, and I get that impulse. I really do. I'm not here to complain about, you know, the Instagram perfect versions of bus life and van life out there. I get it. Not everybody wants to share their dark things, the realities of life, the fact that they have ups and downs and all that with the whole world. So they save their social media posts for the days when it all looks great. But what I'm talking about goes deeper than that. It's the ways we sanitize things, even to ourselves. We don't really want to look at the shit that weighs us down sometimes, you know? And I'm using that word, that potentially offensive word, even though I might push some of you guys away, because it conveys how truly messy this whole process is. It's unsanitary and it's urgent. Maybe you're at the point where you are actually literally weighed down by things. You know, you're still in sticks and bricks. You have too much stuff. You have to sort through it and get rid of most of it, and so that you can become mobile, so you can hit the road, live out your nomad dreams, so that you can fly. And that's a tough place to be in, that place where you are literally shedding, you know, saying goodbye to possessions, because our possessions, the things we choose to surround ourselves with, are part of how we define who we are. There's a reason they're called belongings, and I don't think that's just because they belong to us, but because on some level we belong to them too, and they show us where we belong. For me, I've done that part. I'm past the point where things are the issue. I've downsized enough that my life fits in the 75 square feet that is my bus home, except for a few items that are left over from when I was selling antiques, and one single small suitcase of personal belongings and papers that I can't really get rid of. Other than that, I've created a life that fits physically within the confines of my available space. So that's good, but there is so much more than that weighing me down. The peacock in Song of Solomon, that white peacock, it's a symbol, it's a metaphor for the main character in the book. His name is Milkman. It's for all the things that weigh him down. Things like materialistic values, other people's expectations, his own regrets and resentments, his old ideas, the feeling that he is never going to change, that he's not capable of change, that's the shit that weighs him down. And that is also the shit that weighs me down. Strip away all the things, the stuff. Get in that van that you've been pining for and just go. And then once you do, and I think if you've made that transition already, you'll probably agree with me. Once you've shed all those things, that's when the real work begins. Something about being on your own, or even if you're not on your own, you know, if you're in a caravan, you're traveling with others, but you're without those things that helped to define you. Something about that puts you face to face with all the other shit that lives inside your brain. Because once you strip away the stuff, the things, life continues to happen. And when it does, we react. And there's so much less distraction available that when we react, we really have no choice but to see who we are. Some of that is beautiful. You know, you can see your resilience, your strength, your ability to overcome. But some of it is ugly. Our self-limitations, the judgment that we heap on other people and on the world, our stuckness, the places where we just refuse to grow, material things, responsibilities, the expectations of others, the unfairness of life, all of those things make great excuses for standing still. So you would think that when they were gone, we would just be growing machines, you know, always moving forward once we're free of all that. But that has not been my experience, not right off the bat anyway. I've had to take some hard looks at the shit I am still carrying around. I'm dealing with a lot of medical stuff right now. I'm getting to the bottom of some chronic issues, addressing some problems that I've really just had my head in the sand about for quite a while. And I'm having to learn so many things. The biggest one, the hardest one for me, has been how to advocate for myself and at the same time take the chip off my shoulder. You know, I've had to learn to walk into my medical appointments with the idea that this person sitting across from me is here to help. You know, that this person deserves my kindness, my patience, and my respect, even when in the past, and sometimes even in the present, they have not given me those things. Because if I want to be the person I think I'm meant to be, I have to live the values of that person, whether that's fair or not. Captain's also got some health issues, and that is very scary for me. It brings up the biggest fears I have. Fear that I've failed him, fear of the pain I'm going to go through someday when he leaves me, fear of how much it's going to cost along the way, fear that someday this creature that I love so much is going to be gone. And that hopefully a lot later, but I will be gone too. And fear that I'm not going to leave anything behind, that I won't have a legacy. Fear that once I'm gone, I'm just going to be gone, you know, that there's not going to be anything left of me. And I know this is getting heavy. It's a little too heavy for a casual Sunday afternoon chat, but I am moving through it. I'm taking a deep look at the shit that weighs me down because that's the only way I know how to go through it. And that is messy. It's not polite. It doesn't fit well on a meme. You can't slap a good vibes only sticker on it, but I really want to fly. And no matter what anybody says, I personally can't just manifest that. It doesn't happen through magical thinking. If it does for you, great. But for me, that happens through hard work. What I'm saying is life is going to be beautiful for you when you get out on the road, but it's still going to be life. Shit still happens. And in many ways, it's going to be life amplified, life in your face. But that's part of it. That's whether you even know it or not. That's why you want to do this. Because can't nobody fly with all that shit. You want to fly? You got to get rid of the shit that weighs you down. That's my thought for today. Here's the one without the words. You might need that right about now after all this talking. So check it out and I'll see you next time. Maybe I'll try to combine, you know, talking and not talking in the next one. I don't know. Anyway, thanks for listening.